Many of us take prescription drugs, and oftentimes we're hit with side effects, adverse reactions, some more severe than others. And we can end up taking even more drugs to counteract those effects. But imagine if we could tailor which medicine works best for us.
Revolutionary.
That's how Dr. Monnie Singleton, who practices family medicine, describes the relatively new technology, personalized medicine, also known as designer medicine and precision medicine.
It's the latest technology that is able to design treatments, whether they are drug treatments or medical device treatments, based upon a person's DNA.
Yes, you heard him right. Medicine based on your own DNA, your genetic makeup. Our age, lifestyle, and health all impact how we respond to medications, but so do our genes.
With personalized medicine, looking at the DNA, we specifically focus on looking at the variations of the DNA, what has happened with those genes, the more likelihood of contracting a chronic disease is a result of having multiple genetic variations.
We're talking customized healthcare. Obviously, we're all different. And doctors say those very differences, individual genetic variations, greatly impact our response to therapeutic drugs.
We are beginning to focus more on the genetics because we're seeing that's what's causing the diseases, and that's important in metabolizing the drugs that we are prescribing.
Dr. Singleton is founder, president, and CEO of the Singleton Health Center in Orangeburg, South Carolina. The doctor, who has over 30 years of experience in providing healthcare in rural areas, partnered with Atlanta-based Alpha Genomics Laboratories to provide the required test. He says roughly 20 to 25% of his patients are now on personalized medicine.
I started coming here because I wasn't feeling right. I was feeling lethargic, no energy.
Patients like 32-year-old Jonathan Akis, the father of a 5-year-old daughter and sales rep for a major beer distributor, has always been outgoing.
I like weightlifting. We go hiking. Anything outdoors, I love. Very involved in the community and the church. I help them with youth ministries.
But Jonathan's fun had diminished, and he knew something was wrong.
Dr. Singleton, hey, how you doing?
Dr. Singleton diagnosed him with depression. Using the trial and error method, the doctor gave him samples to try, drugs that generally are more effective and with fewer side effects. And then he wrote a prescription for Jonathan.
I started out with a medication that was working phenomenal, and then after about 4 or 5 months, the insurance company decided not to pay for it anymore, so he started me on a generic. Well, that generic was not right for me because I fell right back into depression.
He became depressed very, very rapidly.
And that's when Dr. Singleton told Jonathan about personalized medicine, and Jonathan took a test that looks at his DNA.
We did the test. Sure enough, the medication, that generic medication that I put him on, he did not metabolize it appropriately. He was a rapid metabolizer, so it didn't stay in his system.
Then it gave a list of appropriate medications, and we got on one of those generics, and then within 2 months, I was back to normal.
One of the things that we have found through research that specifically looks at depression is the more medications a person has tried for the treatment of the depression, the less the effectiveness is. So it's very, very important that we find out the right drug at the right time.
Another buzzword you'll hear in this field is pharmacogenetics, which is a subcategory of precision or personalized medicine.
Pharma, looking at the science of the drug, and genetics, looking at the study of a person's genes and how the genes influence the response that an individual gets from the medication.
Pharmacogenetics tests are most commonly used for drugs used in cardiology, depression, and/or mental illness, and pain management.
What we have here in America now is an explosion of addiction to pain pills, which are called opioids, or in the past called opiates. And I think that we're seeing that explosion, number one, because they're more available, but number two, because they're being prescribed the wrong medications.
And pharmacogenetics tests are especially helpful if you have failed to respond to multiple medications. Undergoing the test itself is pretty simple. While in your doctor's office, a nurse practitioner swabs the inside of your mouth and then sends it to the Alpha Genomics lab. The doctor has the results in about 5 to 10 days.
We can see if the medications that the patient is on are the correct medications. And if not, we can, at that point in time, see what would be the appropriate medication.
Dr. Singleton says that some of the common medicines, either over-the-counter or prescribed medication, simply don't work for everyone.
As an example, when we look at the medications that are prescribed for cardiac arrhythmias, of depression, medications that are for the treatment of asthma, any one particular drug does not work in 60% of the people that are taking them. When we look at, let's say, medications for migraine, when we look for medications for osteoporosis, when we look for medications for arthritis, 50% of the time, that particular drug is not working the way that we think that it should work. Another example that is very, very frightening is cancer drugs and drugs for Alzheimer's disease. They don't work 70% of the time the way that we think they should. Personalized medicine is going to eliminate having to take a drug to counteract the side effects of another drug, because we are going to find out the right drug at the right dose and put you on that medication to start with. And so that is going to really, really impact the cost of care. It's going to reduce pain and suffering. It's going to decrease inefficiencies in the system.
And the doctor isn't alone in his enthusiasm. Statistics show the field is expanding. And just last year, the National Institutes of Health awarded $55 million to help towards a landmark study on the subject.
We're going to, over time, find that this technology is going to help to solve lots of problems with our chronic diseases. And I think that just from the standpoint of being able to eliminate diseases, I think we are going to be able to use this technology and do the same kinds of things with eradication of chronic diseases that we did with smallpox. I'm very excited about it.
Dr. Singleton encourages you to ask your doctor about personalized medicine. And in the meantime, you can learn more at alphagenomics.com or our website, thebalancingact.com.